Yes, I just start off my system. First of all, I go to my browser, and as my browser starts, I'll go to my credential. Yeah, I'll go to my credential. And the site will come like this. Yes. Now, I sign in. Come to manage webinar. My name is there. I am a authenticated user. My class starts 3, 5, and now is 4, so you can get in. Sound testing. Yes, hello. I'm Ronan. Yes, sir. I'm Ronan. Yes, sir. Tested.
You are now
You are
muted.
currently the only person in this conference.
Waiting, boys. Remember, I love everyone. To slide 2. Public chat on. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon.
You are now
Yes.
unmuted.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, yes. Yes, good afternoon to everyone. I hope you can listen to me carefully, yes or no? So you can respond through your particular chat. You can listen to me. One by one, I'll question you. Yes, you can listen to me. Now, can you see the white board in front? Yes, can you see? Yes. Yes, audible. Very good. And can you see the whiteboard in front? Yes, sir. Visible whiteboard. Okay. Now see. Now last day we had done. We had just started the Boolean algebra. Yeah. Okay. And today also I will tell you something on the Boolean algebra, obviously. So our main topic is Boolean algebra. So what we will be doing? Our heading, what we'll be doing is that Boolean algebra. Okay, BOOLEAN, Boolean algebra, ALGEBRA, right? So in Boolean algebra there are various laws. Yes or no? Yes or no? There are various laws. And so firstly, laws. Yes, LAWS. There are various laws in Boolean algebra. So, what laws we will be doing is that we will be doing, first of all, let us see. First, let us know what is Boolean algebra. Okay. In order to do that, I will be going in a slide and showing you the Boolean algebra one. But before that, we have various kinds of things, like in the Boolean laws are there. There is a complementary law, there is an idempotent law, there is an involution law, and there is an associative law. So one associative, A-S-S-O-C-I-A-T-I-V-E. There is an associative law. Yes, there is an associative law. There is also an idempotent law. Yes. So you know these things, these laws are very important. So let us try to find out. Okay. Let us try to find out what are these things. Okay. So in the meantime, you can also, I'll be asking you, as I ask you, you also tell me whether you can see it clearly or not, because this is a new environment altogether. So let us hope for the best work. So now let us see what we can do. We can share one external video. Okay, we can share an external video and see how it works. We can see how it works. So I'm dealing with the Boolean algebra part, right? So let's see how it works. Yes, if I want to share the video to you, so just see and you will respond how it works. Now this we are doing about the Boolean algebra. Yes, just listen.
Good morning, students and class 12. You have a chapter called Boolean algebra. So I want to tell you what is Boolean algebra, because you know to do the problems on Boolean algebra, but at times you don't know what is Boolean algebra. If I ask you what is Boolean algebra, you tell, sir, what is Boolean algebra? You will ask the same question to me. So it's better that I say, what is Boolean algebra? So the class that is on 28/8/2020, you can make a note in your copy. And now you see that this Boolean algebra, how it came. The algebra you know, but why Boolean algebra? Yes, mathematicians and scientists have spent centuries to find the relation between mathematics and logic. So there is mathematics, but now that logic has come, so they want to combine the two. They want to find out the relation between mathematics and logic. And you know logic means your understanding, your way of thinking, that comes a logic. And in programming there must be a logic, otherwise you will not be able to do any program. Now the person who is involved, or the person who brings this, is known as George Boole, and who discovered a link between mathematics and logic. So he found out the particular relationship in the year 1854, and he developed symbolic logic. He developed a symbolic logic, so you can use symbols in the logic. Symbolic logic, which became useful, has become very useful. So this symbolic logic, why it is like we do Boolean algebra, because it is useful to solve logical problems. And problems we find in the particular, or when we do the programs. And what happens in mathematics? Problems in mathematics. To solve logic problems in mathematics. So mathematics, we cannot ignore mathematics. We can do mathematical problems in computer. So how you will be doing? So what is the relationship? And who has brought? George Boole. And now? And this, that to solve logical problems in mathematics, and this one, and this is known as the Boolean algebra. So this relationship that George Boole has brought up, this is known as the Boolean algebra. And you will find that the Boolean algebra deals with either of the two values, that is the true or false. So there can be two possible conditions, true or false. For example, you are doing something or not doing something. You cannot do in the mid of the thing. Okay, And you know, very important things, this particular thing is also important because especially in computers, you have 0 and 1. And the binary digit 0 and 1, and this is a machine language. And the signals are of 0 and 1, that is off and on. This makes a particular way that we can put inside our computer. And for that reason, you will find that it deals with the two values, that's true and false, true, which is 1, and 0, which is false. So these ones and zeros in a group will make up your particular storage in the computer. So this is important. And then the problems will be solved, the management problems will be solved using the logic. And over here, very important thing that you should be doing in Boolean algebra is that you must be knowing the laws of Boolean algebra. So there are various laws of Boolean algebra, which is very important. And in my next class, I will be telling you and rather helping you out how to know the law.
Now, you have understood what is Boolean algebra? Yes or no? Have you understood? I have shown you the video, that is my video only. Yes, very good. So this is very very clear, and it is like elaborately discussed. I even sent the link. If you want to copy the link, you will get it. And now I have already told that we have done the laws, that is the Boolean algebra. What is Boolean algebra? And now what I will be doing is that I will be telling another one that is already I have told about it. That is a law. Yes. What is the law? The law, I told about the associative law. So let's check the associative law, how it works.
Good morning, students, class 12 students and Boolean algebra. Today I'll be telling you about the associative law. Yes, this law allows the removal of the brackets. So you'll find the brackets, you are regrouping the brackets from an expression. You know, this is an expression. Okay, so then regrouping of the variables. So this is an expression. So this expression is regrouped, like this A and B is taken into one group plus C. So it is regrouped. Over here also, this is the first law using the plus operator, and the second law of the associative law using the dot operator, that is the AND operator. A dot bracket, you see, is grouped into B dot C, and it is regrouped at equals to A dot B taken in one group dot C. So we find when we are proving this using the truth table, we find that both are equal. So even if we regroup like A plus within the bracket B plus C bracket is equal to, again, A plus B within the bracket plus C is the same thing. Now, coming to the next one, you see that using the truth table, we must do it. So you have to draw the particular table correctly, nicely, the table, and see A, B, C. So the outcomes will be 8 to the power 3. 3 variables are there. So outcome is it. So you know how to do this. And you find that when you are doing this B plus C, and you are taking the expression as A plus B plus C, and you are regrouping as A plus B plus C, then you find this one and this one are both equal, which shows that even if you regroup with the variables, the particular value is the same. Using the first law, using the plus operator, and in the second law, using the dot operator. Same thing over here, we use the three variables and we find the truth table. Here also we find that this A dot B dot C, this one is equal to A dot B dot C. Verified. Thank you. You understood this? Oh, thank you, everyone.
Yes, hello. Now we come across the next law. Yes, I will be coming to the next law. After the associative law, how I will be telling you what law I will be coming. So let us say what law we will be doing. Yes, for you only, the next law will be just watch what will be the next law. The distributive law. Okay, the distributive law. Fine. So,
good morning, and we have come to another law. Yes, in the Boolean algebra, there
you
is another law that
you
is
are now on
distributive
muted.
Law. Distributive law, the meaning you know, distribution is there. So, how the law is given, you will find there are two laws. That is the first law, which tells A within bracket B plus C. So, it can be done as AB plus AC. You can very well understand from here. If this is the right hand side, is we'll get the result. How we can get? See, right hand side is this side. Okay. And if you write A dot B plus AC, so you take A as common, so it will be A common B plus C, which represents this. So this is proved additively. Now if we come to the second law, that is second distributive law. That is A plus BC is equal to A plus B into A plus C. Now, if we want to prove it algebraically, how will we do that? Very important. So, let us take like this, RHS, right hand side, is equal to this. What is this? A plus B, A plus C. Now, see, if we multiply both the terms, what do we get? Suppose A, so A, first we multiply the older, so A into A is AA, A into C, AC. Now, similarly, if you come to over here also, B, now B into A, AB, and B into C, BC. Up to this is clear. Now, coming to the next part, how we derive this, we know that A dot A is equal to A. So over here, A dot A is there. So this is A. Now AC is there. AC, this one, B, AC is there. We have brought over here. Now AB, AB is here. And BC, BC is here. Done. Now, from here, you see A dot A, this is okay. Now over here, how we bring, we take A as common. So if you take A as common, A into A, hence one, AC is there, so A as common, A into C, and B again, A as common, so B is coming over here. So this term up to here is done. Now the rest remaining term comes here, B dot C. Now, taking A as common is over. Now we come to this one. A. Now see, A plus C, this term. A plus C is equal to 1. So B is there, BC. Again, when you come as 1 plus B, that is also equal to 1. So what happens? Ultimately, 1 into 1 is 1. So over here, A plus C is there. So see it, A plus C plus B is equal to 1. So whole term A plus B, A plus C plus B, we put as 1. Now once we put it as 1, so this term I am just putting 1 for the whole thing. And this BC comes here. I just told you why this comes. Any variable plus 1 is equal to 1. So like that, ultimately 1 comes. 1 plus C plus B is equal to 1. For that reason. Now 1 plus b, which in turn comes to 1. So ultimately 1 is there, so we put 1. Now coming to the next part over here. Now a dot 1 is there, bc is there, a dot 1 is equal to a, so you put a, and bc we put down over here. So ultimately this is the result we get, which is equivalent to.
So thank you everyone for listening to the video and all, and so you have done the associative law as well as you have done the particular what law, tell me. Yes, if you have listened, tell me what law. Yes, tell me, type out. Yes, type out. Yes, I already started typing. So what, which one you have done, which one you have just shown? DISTRI. Yes, distributive law, very good. DISTRI BUTIVE, which is law. So coming to these laws like this, you will have to learn the laws. Okay, so law, I can put it, distributive law is already written on top. So yes, these are distributive law. Now see, so we are having the Boolean algebra chapter, and you know I've told about the zero and ones. So this associative and distributive you have done. So what you have done today is I will tell you what you have done, then again I will come back to gates. So what we have done, just tell me what we have done. We have done this one, the associative law, and now we are going to this once more, and we have come over here. I just minimize this one. Yes, I have minimized this one, and you see we have done this associative law and the distributive law today. Fine. Now you can see me. Everyone can see me. Yes or no? You have to tell me. You have to tell me. Now you can see me or not. Yes. Can you listen to me? You can hear me? Yes. Very good. You can see me. You can listen to me. Fine. So we have done the associative law today and the distributive law, and I have given you. Yes. Very good. Good response. Good. So now see. So we have done that. So there are other laws also. So there are other laws. So what type of laws are there? I am telling you, you just make a note of the laws. Then we have what we call the absorption law. So what is the absorption law? You will write down absorption. Yes, A, B, S, O, R, P, T, I, O, N. Yes, absorption law. So law, I may not write or write law. Okay, so there is the absorption law also. Okay, and what does the absorption law do? The absorption law states that. What does it state? There are two laws. You know, in our absorption law, you will find two laws. Number one law is, I can write like this. Yes, anyone can write down. Come on, anyone can text me. What is the absorption law? First law of absorption. Let me see. What do you type out? Whether you remember or not. Don't remember first law? I make you remember. A is the first letter, dot is there. Yes, audible, very good, very good, audible, very good, fine. So A is there, and then what do you do? The first law, what do you do? A plus what? Yes, trying, A plus A dot B, A plus A dot B is equal to what? Is equal to A. A plus A dot B is equal to A. Yes. Now you verify in your rough copy, you just verify and tell me whether it's yes, yes, very good. You have done A plus A dot B is equal to A. Very good, very good, very good. You can write within the bracket. Buddhaditya, very good. Okay, others also try. Now give me the second law. What is the second law? The second law, yes, second law of absorption. A is there, so A is there, and one bracket will come like this. Yes or no? Then A will come. Okay. Others just type out. What can be done? The next law. The next law. Plus is there. Plus is there. Then B is there. And what comes in? What comes in? A comes in. So is it okay? Just see. Is it okay? Yes. A plus B is equal to A. Yes. This is the absorption law. So, yes, very good, very good. Everyone is doing very good, very good. I want a nice response, and you are doing it. Really, you are also taking the pain as we teachers are doing it. Very good. I like your approach. Okay. So, very good. So, you understood the absorption law. So, now the second part, what comes in the examination is that you prove or verify the law. So, I have done in my tutorials, you will find in my tutorials there is already shown. I don't want to give my videos and all, so I have given. 1, 2 is okay, and then I do my explanation with the board and everything, okay. So, after the absorption, yes, yes Sneha, okay, Sneha also, okay, fine. Yes, Srijita, right, very good, Srijita, all trying, very good. Now, the next one, I have the duster, I am rubbing out, now come to the next point. The next point I come, how many minutes, let me see, 5 minutes, okay, we can go do another law, fine. So, we have done the absorption law is over. And then what, which one we have not done, let me see, which one we have not done. We have not done involution, yes, you can do this one, I-N-V-O-L-U. T I O N, yes, yes, law, L A W. Hope you can see, or I will change my chalk and I'll change my chalk. Wait, I have plenty of chalks. I'll change it. I have colored chalks also. I've got nice dust free chalks, so no dust will come out. Okay, so let me see, involution law. Yeah, I N V O L U T I O N. So everyone, write in your rough copy, and for homework you will be doing that. In your copy you will write all the laws. Yes, all the laws I am doing, mentioning, and involution law. So what does this law state? Yes, somebody is doing it. Somebody is doing it. What does this law state? Yes, tell me. Yes. Involution law. What does it do? It will complement. See, if you complement A, you are complementing A. Yes, complement of a complement is equal to complement of a complement is equal to the particular A. If you complement and you complement back, then A will come. So this is the involution law. Yes, very good, very good. Yes, Srijita, right, Srijita. Yes, everyone should do it. Everyone, not only one. Oh, Buddhaditya is doing, I will be keeping quiet. No, everyone will interact. Yes, and now you try to do this, the truth table of it. Try to do the truth table. I'm moving away. You can't do the truth table. Yes, I know you can do it. But whenever you do the truth table, you do it in particular a chart form. That means you will be doing in chart form the involution law. Okay, and I hope you will be able to do it. I think yes, yes, very good, very good. Well, response Arunima, right? Arunima, you have done it, fine. Involution law and commutative we have done. There is also complementary law, complementary. A plus A bar is equal to 1. We have done that. So all the laws you will be doing, and your work will be to write down the laws in your fair copy. And if you can, you will be also doing the truth table. Okay. First, you write down the laws, and you'll be verifying. I have done in the verification. I have done. Yes, you will be doing that verification. Oh, hope everyone. If you want to see the last of this involution law, I want to see whether I have it. Idempotent law I have. If you want to see, I can show you. Yes, I can show you the idempotent law. Okay, so I can do that if you want. So yes, if you want, sure, I can do it. I will try. Yes, though we have 2.3 minutes left, I will show you this one. So how the chart form is there, that is very important. Just check it out. Yes, do it. 11 law. Okay, so from here you can see it. Thank you.